Good morning and a warm welcome to the students of Srimati R.S. Kalariya Primary School, English Medium, Junagadh. My name is Rakshi Lakhani and today we are going to study about a very interesting topic of history whose name is Effects of the British Rule in India. Before starting this particular chapter, let me say you some of the things about our previous India. Now, the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, has said that we, the Indians only, always giving the chance to the European countries to come to our country India and rule in our country India. He is always admiring and was saying that if we get united, then no one has got the authority to rule or have trade in our country India. So the chapter is completely related to the things which were the effects when British came to our country India. Now the chapter name is, again I am going to repeat, Effects of the British Rule in our country India. Already we have studied that the Sultans, Mughals, Portuguese, French, Dutch, many European countries came to our country India. But the more benefit was being taken always by the Britishers. They just ruled in our country India for 90 years, that is from 1857 to 1947, and they have taken everything from our country India. Now the points related to this topic are, first point, India was economically prosperous till the 18th century as the Britishers came in our country India. But later on, in the mid of the 18th century, when they started ruling in our country India, that was the year 1857. Till then, 18th century, our India was completely prosperous. The anarchy that followed the death of Aurangzeb was considered to be the last ruler of the Mughal dynasty, as Aurangzeb disliked art, music, painting. Apart from that, he was having narrow-minded nature. But then also, after the death of Aurangzeb also, we couldn't get beaten. Now here, he has been admired by historians across the world that till the 18th century, our industries, production, technologies and the organization of trade was best and was unmatched in all over the world. In the same country, India became poorer and poorer and bankrupt during the time of the British, nearly 200 years of the British rule in our country India. So it is always been said that Britishers were the turning point to our country India to rule in our country India. Now here, particular developed or developing nation, agriculture plays a vital role for the development of the nation. Now here, what was the condition of the peasants during that time when the British were ruling in our country, India? Farmers lost, as they were completely just borrowing the money from the money lenders. They had to in return give some, they had to give some surety for their just getting the money from the money lenders. And because of that only, farmers lost their land and agriculture. They suffered in many regions of India. Moreover, when this particular Diwali riot was just being handled and was being started by Lord Cornwallis during that time, it was being observed that many of the farmers lost their land. And because of that only, as Bengal, Bihar and Orissa were under the Diwali riot, Bengal witnessed a terrible famine in the year 1778. Because of that, lots of people died due to the starvation. Because as there was no cultivation of the crop, slowly and gradually in the year 1770, the people, lots of the people were dying. Now here, the Governor General, Lord Cornwallis, enforced Permanent Settlement Act in order to collect the revenue. And it was like that way in this particular Permanent Settlement Act. It was a rule that the farmer, the person, had to pay the taxes on the annual income. Here it is being said that as per the act, this company fixed the revenue on an annual basis, what I said. Now, to collect the revenue, as Lord Cornwallis introduced Permanent Settlement Act, in that particular, the particular revenue was being collected on the basis of the annual income. Now here, the person who was given the responsibility to collect the revenue was given on the shoulders of zamindars, that is the landlords, were given the particular chance to have the collection of the revenue from the people. And because of that only, slowly and gradually, the farmers who are working out for the whole day in the hot sunlight, they are always being exploited. And here it is always being said that the farmers who are working out for whole day, for the whole year, they will completely become bankrupt.
Warren Hastings,
and he was declared as a collector. forms by the company made people insecure and suspicious. The different type of policies that was subsidiary alliance policy, annexation policy, divide and rule policy, Diwani right policy, this all policy which was been introduced by different governor generals from the England, that was British East India Company. We, the people, were always feeling insecure and we were always in a doubt that these particular things which is being made by the Britishers, are they going to benefit us or not? They felt, the people of our country, India, were feeling that they were just admiring that the government was trying to convert our Indian culture completely into Christianity and what would destroy our Indian culture. Now here, it is being believed by the people that was that Indian social system was deliberately undermined in the railways and military. It was being a rule and regulations from the British East India Company that the people who are having the black skin, they were not allowed to just travel in the first class coach. And in that also, it was completely experienced by our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, who was being thrown from the particular coach, saying that you are black skin people. In the same way, military. In the military also, our Indian foot soldiers were being paid 7 rupees as a salary, while the Britishers were being paid ₹150 as a monthly salary. And always the higher posts were always being secured by the British East India Company. Now here, slowly and gradually, when the Britishers started ruling in our country India, they made many strict rules to enter our country India. One of the rules I want to discuss here, an order was passed in Agra. Then when the Britishers were on the road, were walking on the road, each and every person of the citizen of Agra had to salute the person from the small kid to the old age, and if they are not having the salute, then they are considered to be the criminals. Now here, the Britishers have completely destroyed our agriculture, as the peasants, the farmers were completely under the bankrupt, and because of that only our country India farmers were completely destroyed, and that affects the social life of the people of our country India. And slowly and gradually the Gram Panchayats, who were considered to be the backbone and considered to be the small republic for each and every village, was completely destroyed. Now the next target of the Britishers was the destruction of Indian trade and industries in our country India. Previously and during the early ages, our India was considered as golden, was considered as a golden sparrow, and the reason behind that was our agriculture was best. And as the agriculture was completely bad, the things which were being grown in our country India was very much demandable in the market of Asia and Europe. Now here the point is being written that handlooms of India supply textile to the market of Asia and Europe. Now here the Indian made jute, silk, woolen and cotton textile were very much and at a high demand in the European countries. Now this song and delicate muslin of Dhaka was very world famous. But when the Britishers started coming and having trade in our country India, slowly and gradually they understand the situation that the people in the country India don't have a unity in themselves, and because of that only the industries and the trade was also completely demolished by the Britishers. Here it is being said that during the early ages, from the part of Bengal only, comparing this particular 21st century currency, they have earned 500 crores of benefit from the Bengal itself, and it is very very terrific. As India was considered to be the golden sparrow, but due to the particular establishment of British rule in our country India, and apart from that, we the Indians gave them a chance to rule in our country India, and because of that only were not paying the taxes. By the same way, the particular things in a finished product from the factories of England coming to our country India, during that time also they were not paying the taxes. But in our country India, for the person who is manufacturing and who was manufacturing the goods from our country India, they have to pay 80% of the tax to the government. And because of that only, in our country India, the Indian product became very expensive, while the Britishers were earning more and more. And the reason behind that was the import and the export of the goods from one place to another, they were not paying the taxes, and because of that only they were not able to just face the loss. And as they were just selling the particular things at the cheapest price, and then also they were earning more and more. Why? On the other side, our people, the industrial people who were working hard for the whole day, as they were paying 80% of the tax to have the manufacturing of the goods, and because of that only, in the Indian market itself, the Britishers were earning more and more and more. Why? The Indians, the Indian people, the Indian merchants were not able to have the competition in the market of our country, India. Now already our agriculture, trade, industry, production was completely destroyed due to the British East India Company and the different type of Governor General. But we can say that always after the dark, there is always a sunlight. In the same way, when this William Bentinck came to our country India and started working as the Governor General in our country India, he was a person. Yes, we were always in a suspicions about the reforms, about the mailways, telegraph, postal, everything which was being introduced by the Governor General of the British East India. unlike believers, superstitions. We were all